Simon & Schuster Audio presents Heart on My Sleeve, Stories from a Life Well Worn by Jeanne Beker, with a foreword by Linda Evangelista, read by the author.
For Marilyn, who first turned me on to all things cool, and for Ian, who trusted in the magic of the moonlight.
Foreword. When Jeanne asked me if I might consider writing this foreword, I said yes, and then immediately regretted it. I'm a model, not a writer. But then I realized that Jeanne and I are fellow Canadians who have both been obsessed with fashion from an early age, and whose love of fashion helped build a career around it. And the thought of writing this became less intimidating. Let me just say up front that I'll never remember what year or where it was we first met, because, unlike Jeanne, who has a crystal clear memory, my recall isn't so good. However, I'm going to venture that our first meeting was most likely backstage at a fashion show. Which one and where? You'll have to ask her. But it only makes sense that we would have met at a show. After all, we were two Ontarians making our mark in the world of fashion. The backstage area at any given fashion show in the late 80s and early 90s was like no place that had ever existed before, and probably never will again. No one had an entourage, and none of the models were celebrities, at least not at first. And since there were no mobile phones or social media to distract anyone, there was only the steady chatter of hundreds of voices, all speaking, laughing, or shouting at once, gossiping and sharing confidences while a soundtrack of the latest chart toppers blasted in the background. From Paris to Milan, London to New York, models, along with a cast of hairstylists, makeup artists, fashion editors, photographers, and journalists, formed a kind of traveling circus. All of us knew one another, and we had gone to the same parties and dinners, gone to the same shows, and been on the same flights to the next destination. In short, we were a tribe of fashion vagabonds. Amidst all of this was Jeanne, who would appear backstage, wide-eyed and smiling, greeting everyone with a, "How are you doing?" She always spoke with the warmth of someone who actually wanted to know how you were doing. And she was the first journalist who asked models what we thought, not only about the shows we were in, but about our takes on hair and makeup trends and street style. You name it, she asked, and we always answered. Through her show, Fashion Television, Jeanne was able to bring not only the looks from the runway shows, but the energy and irresistible chaos of the backstage into living rooms across the globe. She managed to change the way ordinary people thought about the fashion world, and she made fashion accessible. As a result, many of us industry workers, including Jeanne, became household names, something none of us had ever imagined. One of the most endearing and relatable things about Jeanne is that, as for most of us in the industry, her love affair with fashion began at an early age and never diminished. Like her, most of us can't explain why we loved it. We just knew that we had to be a part of it. And our love of fashion began in small ways, with a favorite blue denim jumpsuit that was worn in almost every photo taken during the sixth grade, or a knit cape made by a beloved grandmother that was the best birthday gift ever. Jeanne's love of fashion, like my own, is rooted in how a piece made us feel, and in the memory of that feeling. These personal connections are so important in understanding our feelings about what we wear, and I think everyone, even if they're not part of the fashion world, can relate to that. As you listen to this audiobook, you'll hear that the beauty of Jeanne's storytelling, and I say storytelling because I believe storytelling is a gift while writing is a skill, is that it's rooted in the lives of her parents, who shared their incredible stories with her, inspiring her to see and experience the world in her own unique way. Now, Jeanne can tell all of us what her journey has been like. Fashion often gets a bad rap for being vapid and frivolous, considering how many crushing conflicts and struggles plague our world. However, I've always found that the magic of fashion is its power to bring us together. No matter what culture or background or socioeconomic group we come from, fashion and how we use it is a commentary on who we are at certain moments in our lives, on how we see ourselves and how we want to be seen. Heart on My Sleeve invites us to recall our own lives and defining moments, where we were, what we wore, and how we felt. I can't think of a better inspiration for those memories than my dear Jeanne. Linda Evangelista.
Introduction: A Wardrobe of Memory. Clothing is an exercise in memory. It makes me explore the past. How did I feel when I wore that? Clothes are like signposts in the search for the past. Louise Bourgeois. From a very young age, I was acutely aware of fashion's transformational powers. My earliest memories are of playing with paper dolls. McCall's, a popular American magazine back in the 1950s, featured a monthly cutout doll named Betsy, along with a page full of her pretty party dresses. My big sister and my mother would cut out all those fantastic garments, and we'd dress Betsy to suit whatever mood we thought she was in, or rather, whatever mood we were in at the time. Later came fancier paper dolls, complete books featuring various movie and TV stars of the era and their ultra-glam outfits, which would dictate more grown-up, exciting adventures. Dressing those glamorous cardboard gals would keep my sister and me occupied for hours. When Barbie arrived on the scene in 1959, I was desperate to have her, but my parents had just purchased their suburban dream bungalow and were counting their pennies. So instead of Barbie, I got her knockoff, Mitzi, a cheap and tawdry version of the A-list doll. I was determined to glamour up as best I could, and thanks to my mother's patience with a sewing machine, we concocted a dream wardrobe for Mitzi, one that lifted her to new fashion heights. In the end, Mitzi outshone my friends' real Barbies, and all of them coveted her spectacular, one-of-a-kind wardrobe. Mitzi taught me the power of original style and the importance of self-expression through wardrobe. As I grew older and my own clothing stash blossomed, I always treasured pieces that made me feel special or confident. All through my teens, my crafty mom made most of my clothing, terrific mod-inspired garments that never failed to garner attention. By the time my TV career started to take off in the 80s, first covering the music scene and then fashion, I had access to an impressive array of designer wares. I began to understand how vitally important it was to develop style consistency, a look that would not only define my image, but allow me to express myself in bold and striking ways. Now, after a lifetime spent playing dress-up, I understand fashion's power more than ever. The clothing and accessories we choose to wear are emblematic of who we are at key points in time. What we wear not only serves to elevate and transform us, but also triggers memories of moments we hold dear. Clothing provides snapshots of the past, revealing how we want others to see us, and how we want to see ourselves. Most women can relate to the excitement of fashion, but my entire life has been steeped in it personally and professionally. For the 3 decades known as fashion's golden age, I was wildly fortunate to have a ringside seat. I attended the world's most famous designer shows, covering them as a host and segment producer for the internationally syndicated series Fashion Television. My unprecedented backstage access allowed me to get up close and personal with some of the greatest creative minds of our time, and all the while, I was given an extraordinary education on the subject of style. I got to learn from the great Valentino, who lamented the fact that fashion's countless options had become so dizzying for women that they no longer knew on which foot to dance. Then there was the legendary Bill Blass, who believed that women who dress in the same designer fair from head to toe are a crashing bore. At fashion shows around the globe, I would sit alongside famous style icons like Andre Leon Talley, Daphne Guinness, and Isabella Blow, all larger-than-life fashionistas who'd mastered the art of dressing. They made me look at my own humble wardrobe in fresh new ways. But more important, I grew to appreciate the backstories of pieces of clothing and accessories, and I gained a new reverence for fashion's possibilities. In the pages of this book, my wardrobe becomes the catalyst for stories about my life. I walk you through memories of jewelry, accessories, and pieces of clothing that have earned indelible places in my mind, because that's what really great fashion does. It creates a feeling that lasts forever. It creates a mood that transcends time. Through these stories, you'll walk a mile in my shoes and get a feel for the memorable outfits I once wore. You'll meet my family and some of my friends who, in so many ways, small and large, inspired my life in fashion. You'll also meet the great fashion and music stars who made an impact on my wardrobe and, more important, on me. My hope is that this book inspires you to look at your own wardrobe in a whole new way. For what is fashion if not an entry point to stories about who we are and how we want to be remembered? The clothes and accessories we choose to wear say so much about us and act as valuable touchstones, reminding us of how far we've come. In her book, Dressed, A Philosophy of Clothes, Shahida Bari refers to items of clothing as the wordless witnesses to our lives. Indeed, our personal garments and accessories offer precious glimpses of our inner selves, far beyond what a mirror could ever reflect. And while clothes do serve practical and perfunctory purposes, the special pieces we hold on to are often keys to treasured memories. Even when we can't actually hang on to our old outfits, the memories of them and of our past selves remain. Please enjoy this intimate look into my walk-in closet of fashion memories. I hope you'll find pieces that resonate with you, that you like, recognize, or remember. Moreover, I hope that through my telling of these personal stories, you'll see how the best outfit of all is a well-worn life. A Satchel of Discovery. The simplest wardrobe accoutrements can sometimes resonate the loudest. The worn old satchel that lived at the back of my mother's bedroom closet for years was a far cry from the glamorous fashion accessories that would one day become so commonplace in my life. But there was a distinct precious quality to this bag, a kind of gravitas that was never lost on me, even as a young child. While the humble old satchel is now lost to time, and I never got to use it myself, the reverence I always had for it is unparalleled. It represented my family's history to me, and what could be more precious than that? My mother brought the brown leather satchel with her when she came to Canada from Austria in 1948. It was stuffed with precious old black and white photos of relatives, most of whom had perished in the Holocaust, some of whom had survived and found refuge at Bindermichl, the Austrian displaced persons camp where my parents lived for 3 years after the war. Miraculously, my parents survived the horrors of the Holocaust. Thanks.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.